we harvest only what we sow. For 65 years, Sears has planted seeds of honesty and of fair dealing and understanding the wants and desires of others. Fall and Winter 1951, Sears Roebuck and Company, Memphis, Tennessee. Yeah, I didn't realize that I was a local thing to Sears customers, past, present, and future. You have in this new catalog for Fall Winter 1951 just about the widest choice of merchandise in America today. A book like this doesn't just happen, it is built on faith. Your faith in Sears' way of doing business, our faith in our ability to serve you in the best way possible. This is what I would like to make sure, because catalogs are printed, prices go down after our catalogs. Okay, well, this is a very thorough letter that they share with the people. Sears guarantee our things. One thing more. Addressed to me personally are always, but oh, they even invite letters back to the manager right here, Dan Aykroyd, general manager. Sears guarantee to save you money, to deliver all merchandise safely to you. So they start out with these cute girls' dresses, some boys' warm clothes and sweaters, girls' dresses. Interesting that they have it in black and, well, not exactly black and white. Here's Day 11's Queen of the West, Honeysuckle Parade of Fashions. I guess Honeysuckle was a name brand or a line of clothing. Some rain gear for young girls. $3.59 for that cute little hat with the bunny tail on the top. Sweet. Boys Western. I like riding pants from days of old. Matchables. These are Honeysuckle. Pants, girls' robes, Honeysuckle flannelette sleepers, cute little kid models from 1950, it's just precious. What do you look for when you buy denims? Yeah, so, a bunch of denim clothing for littles. I think it's so sweet that they start out with children in this catalog. Baby. Oh, babies in their little onesie outfits. Cute. Original. Snow suits. Cute. Socks for littles. Honeysuckle crib blankets. Honeysuckle combed cotton knit gowns and wrappers. Sweet. Honeysuckle training pants. Diapers. Oh my goodness. I remember those old things. For my babies, I mean. I used those on my children. Cute little booties. Cute. Cute. Layettes. And, oh, bassinets. Oh my gosh. Loved those. I had one for my firstborn. Never had a playpen, though, for any of my kids. Strollers, certainly didn't look like that. Nope. shopping cart on that one. How convenient. Johnny Jump Ups, old fashioned style. Playing some toys there. And let's see, baby bottles. Oh, no baby back rub. And here is an order form. Look how old all of these pages look. They're all browned on the edges. Catalog and the order form. I mean, let's see, 1951 and then now 2000. I mean, this is almost 100 years old. Pages are ripping. Another four-star feature. A couple youth beds and cribs. Unpainted juvenile furniture. Interesting. Unpainted. Potty trainers. Vests, mittens, gloves. Those look like ladies' gloves, but maybe just children's things. Versatile twin sweater sets. And Honey Lane classics. Look at those old-fashioned sweaters. Wash vest, t-shirts, panties. Jammerettes. Coats for girls from Honey Lane Rainwear. Yeah, we don't have stuff like this anymore. They're really good covering. See these coats? They're also warm looking and actually would cover quite a bit of you to keep you warm. Sanfordized wash mask shirts. Wacket set. What's a wacket set? I guess they just mean skirts and jackets, maybe? I don't know. Denim jeans for girls. Dresses for girls. These look like preteen age. 7 to 14, that's right. Size of 7 to 14. And then the sizes go with the age. Washable cotton, honey. Are you an almost teen? That's interesting. You wear size 10, 12, 14, 16. Sanfordized classic shirts. It's the smart new neckline that counts. Bell of the Ball, black velveteen skirt. Ooh. I would have worn that. I would still wear something like that. Sanfordized blue denims. With nice vests. Corduroys. Famous Honey Lane coats. Now we're getting into women's young adults. Neat raincoat. Girls' slips. And panties. Sizes 10 to 16. These teenagers. Bright colors. The socks. Yeah, didn't know the 1950s had such brightly colored apparel. Shoes and coats and sweaters. Aw, little booties for little children. I love them. Finest. Lively wedges. Wow, those are something else. Look at these shoes for girls and boys. Looking through this catalog, it's not nostalgic for me necessarily, foot ballerina shoes. It's just like a time gone by that I wish I could have lived in. Cowpoke boots. And the Western wear was a big deal in the 1950s. I think that was about the time that the show Rifleman came out, and we were all still smitten with our Western past. I think we still are, but I know I like watching Westerns. Cute. $4.59 for a jacket. That's amazing. Boys' underwear. Boyville quality winter weight union suits. Double knee denim jeans. See this Western outfit? Isn't that cute? But it's so Hollywood. I wonder if boys actually dressed like that in the 1950s. All these little boys' pants have pleats in them, you can see. Some pajamas for boys. Tailoring extras in Boyville Junior clothing. Those are some nice clothes. Boys used to dress up more back in the 1950s. Socks. Caps. Look at a coonskin cap. I wonder if it was real coonskin. Western shirt. Okay, we have some sweaters here for boys. More Western shirts, robe, oh my, bomber jackets, those are nice, B-15 style, neat, woolens for warmth, Husky Boyville jackets, gabardines, gabardine was a very popular material in the 50s. Wool coat, that's all wool. That's nice. Corduroy was actually real popular. Boy, that looks like Ronald Reagan right there. I remember him wearing a coat like that. Nice tailored suits. The lapels are wider. Look at the pleats. Corduroy, Robux Junior, matched outfits. I wonder what they mean by matched outfits. Stretchy denim dollar. Oh, here's some gloves. Boyville gloves. They're young for the young boys. Call it Western stuff. The guns and. You must measure. Only by measuring can you learn what size to order by mail. Do not guess at your size. You must know your correct size before you order. In other words, don't make us have to take returns. Our bargain rayon dresses. You see all these new nylon rayon type of materials. Those were new, I believe. I don't know, maybe they came out in the 40s, but interesting style dresses. Maternity. I don't see how any of these clothes are for maternity. Look at that waist. I mean, what are they doing? What are they saying? That you're supposed to wear these things tied up. I don't know. Our finest Carrie Brook. Yes. Carrie Brook is apparently the name brand for the women's clothing. Suit dresses. The working woman, no doubt. Five-piece wardrobe. Well, even if you weren't a working woman, you probably could still wear nice things like this. Women used to dress up even just to go to the grocery store. Now we wear pajamas to Walmart. Here's for the petite size women. It's interesting that they didn't, back then they weren't worried about the tall size women. Now we have clothes specially designed for women who are tall and short and medium. For the gracious lady, easy to wear styles. Now see, this was more like home attire. Things that you could just, it would look nice for the hubby when he came home, but not overdressed. I still would never wear a dress. Better by comparison. Four-star feature, only $2.99. Quick tie-back wraps. Oh, I used to love wraparound dresses, wraparound skirts. All percale dresses, bargain priced cotton dresses. Women's fine carry brook cotton dresses. For the gracious lady. And these robes. Wow, I'd like to have a robe like that. With, they look like dresses. That'd be a fun robe to have, I think. Carry book, professional uniforms. Yeah, that looks like for nursing, I think. Doesn't that look like nurses' outfits? All of it. All of it does. Sears, carry book, blouses. Oh, okay. I see a couple of shirts there I might wear even nowadays. You know how styles come in and out of fashion. Low-priced blouse fashions. Made for Sears alone. Superb quality carry brook skirts. Pleat skirt. Yeah, we got some nice designs there. Corduroys. Mix them in 30 ways. Jackets. Well, I see some jackets I would like. Oh, yeah. Our famous Sanford. All these pleats. Look at. Men and women alike wore pleats. I have pleats in the pants I wore in the 1970s. Hercules. Cotton cover-ups. Riding wear. It's so funny looking. I would never wear a pair of pants. It made me look like I had bulging thighs. Sheen gabardine. I did wear a gabardine quite a bit, though. My slacks, not my shirts or sweaters or coats. Purple leaf, suede, cloth. Virgin wool, fleece, coats. Lovely. Now, proper fit for shorter miss, up to 5'4". Priced gabardines. Budget price. Coats. Bargains for a rainy day. Our finest tailored gabardines. under 5 foot 4 inches. That is very petite. Our bargain priced suit. Big values. Some of these suits, they just all start looking the same to me. I can turn 3 pages and say, huh? They all look the same. I'm sure there's little nuances here and there. Zip outs, that's original. Premium wool fleece, rayon, purses, accessories, scarves and stuff. Look at all these purses. My goodness, if you needed to know what purses looked like back then, you could certainly use this as a guide. And the gloves, oh wow, look at these gloves. Carry book classics. Sears scarves. Belts. Sears fashionable blouse sets. What's a blouse set? What does that mean? These hats, fur felts. Look at all these feathers, bows, feather, feather, bow, feather. Interesting. They all do that. Almost every single one of these has. She has netting on hers. It's nice to see that they actually have older women for models in here that would kind of tell you what age group would look best in which hat, I guess, or they're suggesting age-appropriate attire. It is a large variety. Look at this. There are so many women's hats, and they just have a few young animals models there. Bright colors, look at these bright, brilliant colors. Patriotic, hot pink. Ooh, these green sweaters, gorgeous purple. I would take that purple one. I have one like that. I guess it's a classic. It never goes out of style. Carrie Brooke wool classics. Another 4-star feature. Pajamas. Girls' pajamas. And robes. Not robes, they're just... Oh, here's robes right here. These are just nightwear, they call it. Nightwear. I don't know what the difference is between pajamas and nightwear. I wouldn't mind hanging out in that, though. Let's get pretty. Slips. Now we're getting into slips. Style slips and petticoats, cotton slips. I remember wearing skirts that look like those slips. That's awfully fancy. Knit rayon lingerie. Curt knit rayons. Bloomers. Dated the bloomers. Underwear, it's so classic. Full covered. Ooh, umbrellas. Pretty. Wonder what color they are. They go from Embellas to bras. All the bras look the same too. These girdles, oh my god. Can you not imagine having to wear that? Crazy. More bras? They all look the same to me. They all look like Iron Maiden. Okay, so bras, girdles, on and on here. Bras, girdles. They all look the same to me. Except this one opens in the front. Not sure what the point of that is, but interesting. Bras, girdles. Underwear, slips, wow, just a comprehensive amount of underwear for women in this catalog. It's crazy. Now, here, getting to something more interesting. I remember these. I think I had something like that when I was a kid in the 1960s. Nylons, proportions of nylons, super twist, our finest super twist. Remember the lines in the back? I never wore them, but I've seen them in movies. The seams, they're just actually seams in the back of the leg. Winterweight hosiery. Opera pumps, enchanting pumps, fashion gems. Interesting. These styles are actually quite charming, so many of them. Look at that one. And it's party time. Tailored elegance, midway heels. Some pretty high heels on some of these. Pennywise partygoers, finest flats. Some of these shoes are just darling. Oh, I wouldn't wear these, but they're cute. Purse happy prices, fancy free casual, happy stepping wedges. Ladders. Comfort wise, top quality casuals. Softly casual. Straps are news. It's very strappy. High stepping. Hand sewn. Saddleback shoes. I remember saddle shoes. I think I even wore a pair when I was young. They stuck around for a long time because that had to be 1960s. I like that, how old fashioned. That looks like something an old lady would wear in an old movie. It's so funny. Look at that. That is so Hollywood classic of somebody who was... Look at those heels. God, no way. But some of these shoes, look, they're so, high heels, and I mean, how's anybody gonna be working those? Nice. So, some of these are just like really darling, and some of them are just downright ugly. Look like something the Wicked Witch of the West would wear. The Wizard of Oz. Or the evil stepmother. Huh. Those are funny looking, but they'd be fun. Men's slippers, I think. Those look very familiar, like my dad wore. Ties that tell a story. Those don't look very fine. Those do, though. Those robes. Ooh, look at the nice gloves. I'll bet you things were so much better quality back then, in general. Men's caps and hats and gloves. Western cowboy hats, some of them. Pilgrim hats. What's happening here? Oh, it looks like a factory goop up there. That's why it's folded over. Corduroy. Corduroy was pretty popular right into when I was a teenager. By the time I was a teenager, the big deal was brushed denim. Really super soft. I see shirts for men. Pilgrim tops. Feature whites, solid colors. Pajamas for men. Nice shirts. Sports shirts, they call them. Authentic Scottish clan plaids. I love those. I love those plaid shirts. Sweaters. Mm-hmm. More sweaters. Tips to trappers. Lightweight union suits. I wonder why they call them union suits. I just figure they're long underwear. Union. Oh, probably another word for one. Like onesies for men. Pilgrim. Nylon underwear for men. Broadcloth shorts. What we call boxers nowadays. T-shirts. Now we're getting into some pants. The men and boys and women, they all have pleats everywhere. None of the pants have regular front pants without pleats. And there is a line, a ironed crease in front of every single one of these pants. I remember ironing pants when I was young and trying to make sure it stayed on the crease. Oh, look at these coats. They're like spy coats. Super spy. Or private detective. They're just raincoats, though. Water repellent, they say. Wallets. Raincoats. Hercules rainwear, that says. That's pretty thick for the working man. Socks. More socks. Colorful. Very colorful. Pilgrim, I said. So these are like uniforms. Here's more uniforms. They're calling them something else, though. They're calling them matched outfits. I wonder why they call them matched outfits. Hercules, Hercules is the brand name, I guess. This clothing line. These are like overalls with the work pockets. Denim pieces for the working man. Look at these jackets though. Those are neat. Sheep-lined Mackinaws. Bomber style. B-15 bomber style. My husband loves that style of jacket. He's not brave enough to wear it. He's got one. He's still not brave enough to wear it. Nice. These are nice. Nice jackets. Gabardine. Hercules. Leather jackets and wool jackets. More bomber jackets. Nice leather. I like them. Isn't that nice? I sometimes think I'd like to wear a man's jacket. Men's, boys, Romeos. All kinds of different shoes here. Got slippers and slip-ons, dress shoes, and boots. Gold Bond is the name brand for these dress shoes. Dress shoes for men. Very nice. I don't like the real pointy ones. I like the round toed shoes. Pre-flexed, I don't know what that means. These must have been real styling at the time. All the sewing and seams. Comfort, Gold Bond, genuine kangaroo. Wow, it's made of kangaroo. Well, I guess leather can be made from any animal skin. Waterproof, waterproof. You walk on air, another 4-star. Rugged combat type boot. Horse hide. Oh no, seriously? Horse hide shoes. I guess if you can make them out of cows, you can make them out of horse. Kangaroos and horses and cows. Leather comes from somewhere, does it not? Husky oil tanned wear faster boots. Hip high boots. And some tennis shoes. This is what we style our Converse shoes after. Talons and purses. You got some wallets again and little miscellaneous things. There's a way to make it, as it's for dresses, to make dresses on. It's a form. A flexible one that goes to your shape. And then scissors and yarn. Here's yarn. Hobby shop. Knitting yarn. Okay, more yarn and strings and bunch of lace. Different kinds of lace you can get for trim. Trim lace. Flings. Plan a wardrobe. this is materials that are for sale, different kinds of material. Look at all these colorful prints. You can just buy yardage to make your own clothes. Wow, those are so classic, old cottons. It's all cotton. Mostly. Oh, here's some gabardine materials. Taffetas, satins. Rayon. Cloth and napkin sets. These are tablecloths and nice fine table coverings. Table pads and cotton scarfing. Anything you need to dress your table for. I think these are dishcloths. Kitchen toweling, sacking. Look at the cotton lace tablecloths. My mom used to have one. Always had one. Shoe holders and closet organizers. Here's a whole closet right there. Look at all these miscellaneous storage and organizing things. Hair clips, dishes now. See, this is semi-porcelain dinnerware. I've never heard of semi-porcelain. Here's china. Look at all these designs. I believe they have a chicken in there. Amazes me. Stemware. Glassware. Getting into some silverware here. That looks like something I've got of my husband's mother. Used to have it. It's real silver. Back then, it really was silverware. Oh no, here's this silver plated. But I recognize these designs. Colors in your home will go together. Treated for washability. Blankets. Wool, part wool. Ooh, I remember these styles. Totally reminiscent. Those especially, very nostalgic. These are comforters. Window and shower curtains. Heavy gauge plastic, so they just sold plastic. So you could make your own tablecloth, I guess. Or curtains. Here's some cotton fabrics. And some terry toweling. Pillows. Boy, there's everything. Bath towels. Look at those. They're gorgeous. Pastel muslin sheets and cases. Come in a nice little container. Mattresses, mattress covers. What is that? What are they? Little roll-out mattresses, maybe? Cheesecloth covered. Bats. Oh, bats. So they go inside of your duvet. Okay, blinds, Venetian blinds. And these are the shades that roll down, and they sell the little extra trim here for the bottom of your blinds if you want to get fancy. Whoa, look at those yellow curtains. I've never seen curtains like that in anyone's house ever. These are so delicate, pretty, lacy curtains, more curtains. Now I have these kinds of curtains on my windows in my house right now. Those. Not all the ruffly stuff, just the straight lace. More curtains, more curtains. Now these are plastic. What are they talking about? I've never actually heard of or seen plastic curtains. It makes sense for a kitchen though, doesn't it? Rayon panels. Sherback, Priscilla's. Upholstery and repair supplies. Interesting. Drapery rods. Everything you need to hang your curtains and drapes. What are they? Oh, yes, they're cushion covers. Okay. Cover your cushions. They're just, if you want to cover your furniture. I've got every size there, looks like. Heaviest two-way stretch slip covers. Slip covers, more slip covers. Here's house decorator fabrics. I guess that's also for just whatever around the house. Plastic Faber light, liquor light. Pebble cloth. Everything in here. Bedroom luxury. Ruffles for your bed. Oh, nice bedspreads. And all these good different. Oh, heirloom chenille. My mom had that. I have that on my bed. Light fixtures. Boy, does that look familiar. That is totally, I remember that one. $4.95, that's like a lot back then. All these different light fixtures. Lamps. Just wall lamps, floor lamps. Here's a bunch of just little home decor. Ducks, flying geese, Indian heads. Oh my goodness. Look at these. I recognize those. Totally. Drum table. I have that. I have a drum table in my attic. That's just like what I've got. I remember, totally remember this furniture, that. Tables and chairs, we had those. We had those. Bed, oh, I had one of those. This little vanity. Waterfall is the name of the furniture I have up in my attic. right now. I just got it from an antique store about 4 years ago. I don't think I could ever buy something like that. It's brilliantly gorgeously red, but I still couldn't. I couldn't. Look at this. So just brilliant colors. Wow. I guess the 1950s were just really into bright colors. Rocking chairs. Red. Goodness gracious, that is a brilliant red. Mattresses. Inner spring mattress. Extra firm mattress. Back springs. There's the springs that go inside. There's trundle beds, bunk beds, dressers, little tables for women, vanity type things, more dressers, bedroom sets. Units, desks and chairs, dining set, wood kitchen cabinets. There's something in here that looks familiar. I think that looks like an old Hoosier, except it's a little more modern. Baking cabinet, basically. 1950s. Still long enough ago to where they didn't have all of the modern amenities yet. Area rugs. Large area rugs. Wow, those were just loud. Brilliant. Wow. Look at all these carpets. Westminster. Those are pretty. I like them. I'd use those. And oh my gosh, how classic. So nice to know that they still had those in the 1950s. I'd get that. Well, I have it actually already. Back in the 1950s, women would still want those. Floor coverings. This is heavyweight. It looks like vinyl. Textured inlaid linoleum. So you could actually, I bet that was really heavy duty though. That looks so retro. Oh my gosh. Kitchen work surfaces. Things you need to put all these things together. Rug cushions. Fireplace screens. And irons. Oh my gosh, televisions. $339.95. Thought I could get a TV for that price now. Wow, that was, wow, expensive. Because that's when TV was first coming out. Deluxe silver tone. Clock radios. Radios. No, I think they were just radios. I had one that looked just like that. radios, records. Instruments, oh well, guitars. More guitars, more instruments. Got a clarinet and some harmonicas. Pianos. Oh my gosh, I could get a piano for that price. I could get one today. And nowadays, accordions, jump from that to vacuum cleaners. Kenmore sewing machines. Sewing machine tables. Refrigerators, oh my gosh. Wow. They're so retro. Look at, oh. And these are washing machines. Oh my gosh. Can you imagine? I can't even imagine. Look, they all have ringers at the top. Wow. Can you imagine? It would still be so much worse. Now see, that seems modern to me. I don't know they had that back then. I wouldn't have used it back then, and I don't now. There's a coffee pot and a waffle iron. Electric table stoves and popcorn popper. Fascinating. Yeah, I used to have one of those. Never had a fryer, though. Fan. I have a fan like that. Irons. Stoves. Stoves, ovens, I would say. Wood range. Ooh, I would love to have a wood range. Kenmore. Gas heaters. These are kerosene heaters. This is a wood burning stove, isn't it? That one, that looks like one I've had before. Radiant oil heaters. You know, my husband and I use a radiant oil heater right now, and they are so effective. $21.50 for that. That's not very much money. Oil circulators. Freezers, freezer paper, dairy products and stuff you could wrap your meats in and put in the freezer, cold spot packaging, step stools, oh my gosh, I love those step stools, and we had, I bought one of those recently, but we these clotheslines, and I have that clothes basket. Of course, they're reproductions, but I still had one. I have one. What is this? Wood stretcher. What do you stretch? Okay, household goods for cleaning. Oh, I have one of those too. pattern scales, laundry baskets. You know, a lot of this stuff in here my mom had, she still had when I was a child. Aprons. My mom had a meat grinder. She had one of those too. I have one of those. They never go out of style. Pressure cookers. Now we had one of those too because I helped my mom can peaches and different fruits after the harvest. Coffee pots. Okay, rings, jewelry. We're getting into some jewelry here. Bracelets. Rings. More rings. Rings. Necklaces, watches, Orvin for 51, wonder what that means, expansion watch bands, Orvin for 51, Bulova, Elgin, I've heard of Bulova watches before. Tower watches I've never heard of. Tower pens. Hearing aids, pens, cuckoo clocks. That. Clocks, wall clocks, alarm clocks. Those look classic, don't they? Okay. Binoculars, books, cookbooks, better homes. There's the joy of cooking. That doesn't look like the one I own, but children's books. The Holy Bible. King James Version. Got some scrapbooks, picture frames, briefcases, art supplies, crayons, pens, paints. Oh my goodness, typewriters. Portable typewriters. Pencil sharpeners and calculators, full-time secretarial office supplies, plastic playing cards. Wow, that's interesting. Light bulbs. Cameras. That's actually lighting equipment for professional lighting. I remember those. A projector screen. My dad had one of those because of the slides he liked to show everybody every once in a while. Really retro camera as well. Phone service. Oh, look at that. You could tint your hair on your own. Cold spot freezer ad. There's another order form. Actually, there's a name on that one. Okay, Okay, here's some beauty supplies, and the pages are coming apart here. Oh, look at all the things for women. All these mirrors and brushes and beauty sets. Oh my gosh, I remember that clearly by Cody. They kept their pattern there forever. They haven't changed it yet. Perfumes by Yardley. Max Factor. Ponds, Revlon, that's crazy. They're all still here. Some things just last forever, don't they? Deodorant soap, and oh, here we're getting into some vitamins. Aspirin and pain relievers. Vitamin A and D, vitamin B12, Anacin. I remember Anacin. What is that? Lose weight. Now, why do they have more girdle stuff back? Oh, here's your feminine hygiene. I've seen those before. I don't think I ever knew what it was when my mom had it sitting around her bathroom. Hot water bottles. Urinals. Day and night urinals. Those look like catheters of type, maybe. Relief from hemorrhoids. Wow, they really got detailed in these catalogs. So all of these things are for your health. Wheelchairs. Crutches. Okay, here's some home supplies. Roofing tiles and asphalt floor tiles. These are building supplies. Things you can do it yourself around the house. Sort of if you were gonna go to Lowe's. Blocks and walls, coverings, and electronics, wall sockets, and paints. Now we're in paints. We've got all different kinds of paint supplies. Rain getters, paint brushes. Wow, you could just get just everything in this catalog. Ladders, more paint supplies, toilet seats. Wow, bathtub sets. It's looking like Lowe's catalog. Could get so many building supplies. Look at this. Mirror sets, kitchen cabinets, sinks, water heaters. My goodness, look at all these little detailed things to outfit your home with. Now we're getting into some more of this. Perfect. three type tools. Canvas, water repellent, tarpaulins, they call them. Motor scooters, wow. Okay. And these are seat covers for the car. Interesting. Coupon, car tires, snow tires, car jacks, tire jacks, accessories for the car. So now we're in the auto zone, in the auto parts store. Sunglasses. See if I can do a flip through the last part of this, because honestly, even back then, car supplies did not interest me. Okay, go to the back and we have the index. We could look up the area that you wanted to find something. Very end of the catalog has all these miscellaneous things for the farm, for keeping the animals healthy. Auto parts, saddles, wagons. All seeds. Yeah, look like this last whole part is for your yard. Your animals, tools, big tools, saws, electric saws. Wow, everything you need in every briefcase, bicycles, axes, just wow. That is something. That's it. That was fun. And I hope you enjoyed that look back into the 1950s. Thank you so much.